Welcome to Strength of Materials. Topic is related to simple stress and strain. So we have seen the numericals related to elongation of bar. In this video also some numericals are there. Numerical on elongation of bar only, but the questions are of different type. Clear? The safe stress, see, the safe stress of a hollow steel column which carries an axial load of 2.1 into 10 raised to 3 kN is 125 mega Newton per meter square. If the external diameter of the column is 30 cm, determine the internal diameter. So to make you clear, first of all, the stress is given. Stress is given, that is safe stress is given of 125 mega Newtons. This you can also see here, mega Newton per meter square, safe stress. So this, when we convert mega into the Newton, mega means 10 raised to 6. Please keep this in mind, 10 raised to 6. 2125 into 10 raised to 6 Newton per meter square is the stress at now presently. So the given question is to be read thoroughly, and then we have to write the whatever values are given in the question. Now, hollow steel column. Hollow means which type? Hollow means when we remove the refill of the pen, we are able to see this as the hollow section. When we remove the refill of the pen, we are able to see the pen as the hollow section. So to show you, I'll take this part of pen. When I remove this particular refill from the particular pen, you are able to see this particular section. This is the hollow section. Now this, I keep it in this vertical direction. When I keep it in vertical direction, this will be as a column. This will be as a column. Now we have to draw here. So what is given data? External diameter, the column diameter is given data, and internal diameter, this internal part, the internal diameter, is to be known to us. So this is the determination of internal diameter. So let us see how to find out this particular internal diameter. Clear? So this figure I'll also draw at this particular place. So consider this as the hollow section plan, what you have seen, and this as the internal diameter. So this, let us keep this as a small d and the external diameter as the capital D. Clear? A column means it is vertically, but we are not able to see this as exactly. So let us, I'll draw the dotted line here. Internal diameter it is. Diagrams, because of non-familiar gadgets. Then axial load. How much is axial load given? Axial load is given like this. This is the P value which is given on this. P value which is given on the particular column. It is 2.1 into 10 raised to 3 kilonewtons, means 2.1 into 10 raised to 6 newtons. So simple, we have to find out kilo will be into 10 raised to 3 itself only. External diameter 30 centimeter, which is 0.3 meters. All dimensions are kept in Newton and meter. Let small d be the internal diameter. Now, area of the cross section of the column. So this area, this particular area, we have to determine only this much area, not other than area, this area. Agree? So that is, area is equal to pi by 4 capital D square minus small d square. We are left out with only the shaded area. So when we keep the capital D as 0.3 and small d as d itself only, so area comes as pi by 4 0.3 square minus d square. This is the bracket close. Now using the equation of stress P by A, that is load acting on that area. So when we come to this area is unknown to us now. Area is unknown because this part is the formulation of area unknown nation. So in this particular formula, in place of area, this part we have to substitute in place of area. So how we have to write this? 125 into 10 raised to 6 is equals to, sorry, that is equal to 2.1 into 10 raised to 3 whole divided by, area is what, pi by 4 capital D square, that is 0.3 square minus small d square. This part we have to find out here. Now when we substitute and cross multiply the things here, this will come as d is equal to square root of 0.09 minus 0.02139. So it is d as 0.2619, that is 26.19 centimeter is the internal diameter of the particular column. So this was the question which was asked in the external exams. So be careful about these type of questions. It was ranging of about marks, 10 marks for this particular question. Second, next is a uniform steel rod 6 mm dia and 0.5 meter long is subjected to a tensile force of 3 kN. Find the stress in the bar and its elongation capital E equal to 200 GPa. Stress in uniform bar. So we need to know that uniform steel rod is there. Uniform means diameter is same. So uniform steel rod. You try to draw the particular figure with respect to question before you write any given data, so that it will be making you more clear to understand the problem. 6 diameter, so this dia is 6 mm, then 0.5 meters long, this is 0.5 meters long. Till you don't draw the figure as per the question, it will not be much clear for you. So 0.5 meter long and is subjected to tensile force, means it is a pull, so it is 3 kN. Write it, 3 kN on the both the sides. This is 3 kN, this is also a force 3 kN. Clear? Find the stress in the bar. Stress in the bar means what is required. We required only sigma, that is equals to P upon A, stress in the bar, and its elongation E, and its elongation, and its elongation is required, that is the delta part of elongation is required, length increase in the particular section, delta is required. Then E is given, how much? Young's modulus, it is E, Young's modulus, 200 GPa. So G means giga, we have to understand, G means giga means we are to put 10 raised to 9 here, 10 raised to 9, clear? Then Pa means Pascal, that is Newton per meter square, or we can say Newton per mm square also. If we consider Pascal it as, it is Newton per meter square, we convert it into Newton per mm square even. So now finding out, tensile stress is known to us, this part. Area of cross section we will find out, pi by 4 d square. So here I have written it in the other format. I will just show this how to write pi d square by 4 I have written. So this is pi d square by 4, which is 28.727 mm square. This is square, just make it on the top side. Square, then stress is P by A, P by A it is, we are substituting, calculating, then we are able to get this as the stress. Here one value will be coming of the stress, So this stress value, I'll just tell you for a moment while this I think got erased in the particular section moment. So I'll write it. Yeah, stress is 106. This 6 is coming downwards, it is not raised, it is 106 itself only. So 6 is 106 Newton per mm square. Change in length is how much? Delta L is equals to delta L PL by AE. PL by AE. So this is P 3000 Newtons. L 0.5 into 1000 in mm we are taking. Area, this is AE, E is this particular part, divided by 10 raised to 6 to convert this into meter to mm we are considering this part. Note that 1 GPa is equals to 10 raised to 9 Pa, which is equals to 10 raised to 3 megapascal, which is also is equals to 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm square. Clear? So when we calculate this particular calculation, we are able to see that delta is equals to 0.265 mm for this particular question. This was asked for 5 marks in your external exams. So please be prepared. Then coming to next part, the length of the aluminium rod is 10 mm dia and 400 mm long, increased to 4.15 mm only, this is 4.15 mm, when subjected to a tensile force of 2 kN, find the stress in the bar and the value of E for aluminium. So determining is only stress and E. We need to understand only stress and E. So what is the stress value? P by A. Okay. And what is the E? That is stress divided by epsilon. That is strain we need to find. Clear? So what is the stress now? P by A. P is given. Area we have to find out of the 10 diameter. That is area of bar is equals to pi d square by 4, 78.54 mm square. Stress, it is 2 kN, 2 into 1000 divided by 78.54, which comes out about to 25.46. So we are having the value of stress now. Clear? Now we need only Young's modulus. To find Young's modulus, we need to have epsilon. This epsilon is nothing but the strain value. Strain is what? Change in length upon original length. Change in length upon original length. So finding to this, so change in length is what? Delta L 400.15 minus 400. So this is the change of length. Let us take this as L dash. This is the original length, L capital, minus when we do, we get some changes of the dimension, that is 0.15 mm. Now delta L is known, this part is known to us, PL by AE I will substitute. So this formula is again cross written in the terms of the particular thing. So how we are going to consider? So this is delta L by is equals to PL by AE. It is PL by AE. E is required, I'll take this on this side and this again on the denominator side. So how it will be, again changing the formula, E is equals to P L divided by A area multiplied by delta L. This is the part which is written here. Substituting the known values in this, we are able to find out what is the E, Young's modulus for the aluminium, which is 67,906 Newton per mm square. This we can write it in terms of gigapascal as 67.9 GPa. Clear? Hope you have understood. If any doubts are there, please comment in the comment box. I'll be answering for those comments. Thank you. See you in the next video.